السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء. واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. الحمد لله brothers and sisters, we are back again. And we just have to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this awesome bounty that He has blessed us with. And I hope by now that you are really feeling the bounty of sitting in these classes, because I'm sure that you are seeing the Quran, you are seeing many things in the Quran that you didn't see before. But what I want you to do is to concentrate on those surahs and ayatul kursi that we memorized. And the surahs that we are going to be memorizing in these lessons that we are going to be doing for part two of foundation one. Alhamdulillah, brothers and sisters, we welcome you to our fifth lesson, Ad-Darsul Khamisu of part two of foundation one. It is our 21st lesson, Ad-Darsul Hadiya wal Ishroon, overall for foundation one. And we are very, very, very grateful to our Lord Allah for this majestic opportunity to be involved in studying and teaching this important language, this important aspect of this deen, alhamdulillah. This lesson will be discussed over the following: analysis of Khutbatul Hajjah. We are going to have a grammar section. We're going to be doing involved in Quran studies. We're going to have a Tajweed page and important daily words that Muslims should know. So we're going to continue from here. Analysis of Khutbat al-Hajjah, reading of the section chosen, roots of the words and their meanings. So we have, this is the part of the Khutbat al-Hajjah that we are going to do. And I didn't discuss anything on the Khutbat al-Hajjah because we are going to be studying the meaning of this today here, inshallah. Let us read, inshallah, all of us. Wa ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. Everybody can read that. Let's read it again. وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. Yeah. So we have أَشْهَدُ, which is the fi'l mudari', right? It comes from shahida yashhadu, which is a form one verb that occurs 160 times in the Quran. This verb, in all the different ways it is used, occurs this amount of time in the Quran. As shahida yashhadu, it occurs for the four times. So the past tense and the present tense, it occurs that amount of time, inshallah. It means to witness. Shahida means to witness. Yashhadu means he witnesses, or shahida can also mean he witnessed. It also implies to see with one's own eye. to see with one's own eyes, to be present at public appearances. So you see it, you're witnessing it, you're present at something. It is called a shahada, a witness. You're witnessing to it. The other form, four, which we're going to be dealing with, inshallah, in the next trimester, is it has an alif, a hamza added to the beginning of the shahid, to the beginning of the word shahida. You add alif at fatha, so it's a. You take out the sukoon, the fatha from the sheen, and you add a sukoon, so it becomes ash hada. As you notice, it ends with a fatha. This is a sign that it is past tense. And look at the present tense. This is yashhadu. This one is yushhidu. Right? And you're going to see this a lot. Now, one thing with the form four, and this is in the Hanzwar dictionary. I don't know if you know about it, but we'll talk about that later, a little later, inshallah. What you notice about this form is that it always take a dhamma on the force, on the alamat al-mudari. So it becomes yush, yush, yash, yush. Right? Like anzala unzilu. Now, the only form for the present tense, it is with the kasra. Ashhada yushhidu. Ahmada yuhmidu. Anzala yunzilu. So the form is easy to memorize. Ashhada yushhidu. Af'ala yuf'ilu. Right? Whereas this here has six forms as we discussed before. Now, this means when you see anything added to the Arabic, triliteral verb, this is three-letter verb, it's triliteral, right? It means that there's additional meaning, there's some addition to the meaning or some difference in the meaning, there is something different, right? Now, this verb here occurs seven times in the Quran in a different form. And it means to call as witness. Istashhada means to be martyred, right? And this is used twice in the Quran. And the noun shahada is a witness. It's used 23 times in the Quran. Is a testimony. It is used 23 times in the Quran, inshallah. Shaheed is witness. And so, and also, it can mean you're a shaheed if you witness to something. But a witness also, shaheed is called, a martyr also is called shaheed. We heard this a lot. He's a shaheed or whatever the case may be. This is used 56 times in the Quran. As the active particle, shahidun. I am a shahid to something, I witness to something, right? It is the one that is witnessing to something. Okay? That is used 21 times in the Quran. And mashhud, which is the passive voice, which means the thing that is witnessed. And in Surah Buruj, we see Allah use the term, wa shahidin wa mashhud. Okay? The passive voice, the mashhud, the thing that is witnessed three times. It's something that you witness that is happening before a crowd that is witnessed. Okay? So, inshallah, I mean, I hope this gives some insight into that word. The other word that we are dealing with is ilah. Ilah here. Ilahun come from the word aliha. Sorry, not aliha. Alihatun is the plural of ilah. Alihatun is many gods, many deity that are taken as worship. Ilahun is one deity. Okay? Ilahun is one deity. So the meaning is deity, deities. Alihatun is deities. And the root is alif, lam, and ha. And it can be translated as gods also. Okay? Normally translated as gods also. So, now that we have that, wa ashhadu, shahida means he witnessed. Yashhadu means he witnesses. Ashhadu means I witness. And I witness. So after saying all that you said, Alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu, nasta'inuhu, nastaghfiruhu, which are all talking about very important characteristics that a Muslim must have. Of hamd, he must praise Allah, he must seek his help, he must seek his forgiveness, he must seek Allah's protection, believing that only Allah deserves all of these. Allah alone deserves to be praised. He alone we can seek help from. He alone can forgive us our sins. He alone can really truly protect us. Right? And then he alone can guide. Whoever Allah guides, none can lead astray. And whosoever he leads astray, none can guide. Then we say, wa ashhadu. So I witness. After all of this, on top of this, I witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah. La ilaha illallah. So it is really an emphatic thing, because after expressing all of these important attributes that a Muslim must have, he's saying that, yes, well, I witness that this Lord who possesses all of this, and who I have to devote all of these things to, I witness that he is the only true deity worthy of worship. And then I said, this is la nafi'a lil jinn. So it makes this ilah here mansub. Okay? And it negates everything that is worshipped, except illa Allah, except Allah. وحده لا شريك له. وحده means one alone. He is alone. لا is لا نافي للجنس again. لا نافي للجنس, the type of lam, لا that makes the noun that come after it mansub. That's the first thing, and it negates every single thing. So in this particular case, there is no exception. In this case, where it negates all objects of worship, it then established that there is only one true object of worship, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the truth. He's the true God. Now, la sharika, there is nothing after it, because there is absolutely no sharik for Allah. Sharik means a partner. Shuraka is a plural, right? Sharikun shuraka'u. There is absolutely no sharik for him. Okay, so there's no exception here. It's a straight up. And he's alone, and he has absolutely no partners. Washhadu, same thing here. That, ashhadu, same concept here. An eyewitness also. That Muhammad is his abd. We said abd is slave, right? Abdun, ibadun is plural, right? Abdun, ibad is abdun is slave, ibadun is slaves. Rasulun from Ra, Seen and Lam, right? That's its root. It means one messenger is Rasul, messengers is Rusul. Sharik comes from Sheen, Ra and Kaf, right? So, I mean, we must start to picture the root of words when we see them. Like this one, I didn't put it, but that's because I discussed it so much before. It's from Ayn, Ba and Dal. So, ashhadu anna, I witness anna, we said can mean that, or it can mean that certainly Muhammad is his. We're coming back to Allah, right? This one Lord, Allah, this one deity that is to be worshipped, Allah. He has a slave that he sent as a messenger, his final messenger is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, so we witness, so the ha here returns to this Allah, to this noun here, which is Allah. Okay, ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu abdullah wa rasuluhu. Okay, and I witness that indeed Muhammad is his slave and his messenger. Okay, let us get the i'rab here. This is fi'al mudari marfu', because it has a dhamma. We said anything with dhamma is marfu', it's fi'al mudari, right? It's not madi. And this harf, this waw is harf, and this an is harf, and the la is harf. All of those are huruf, right? An here also means that. Illa is also another harf. Ism is ilah, and Allah, those are asma, right? This one is mansub, the fatha, because of the la and afil al-jins. This is marfu' because it has dhamma. It has a dhamma, right? Marfu' means it has a dhamma. Mansub means it has a fatha. Harf again, huruf. The huruf here we have is la. No, this here is wrong, right? I expect that was going to come up. This is not a harf. This is from the word from wahada, wahid, wahdahu. He's alone, right? La sharika la. This is ism. Wahdahu is the ism. That's correct now. And the ha after it is also an ism, because it goes back to Allah, wahdahu, he alone, talking about Allah. Sharik is ism, lahu is harf, harful jar wa majrur. This is harful jar, and what comes after it, this is an ism, because it is damir, all damir are ism, and it is majrur, fi mahalli jar, because it is mabni, this word is mabni, damir and mabni. It is majrur and fi mahalli jar. This one, fi'al mudari marfu' is ashhadu again. Anna is harf. And the waw is harf again. And this waw is called waw al-aqf because it continues from this. So it is this waw here is a conjunction which joins this sentence to this sentence. So it makes it one sentence. Anna is harf that wa rasuluhu. This is conjunction again. This waw al-aqf kazalik here, right? Ism, we have Muhammad, we have Abd. Abduhu is an ism, but it is mudaf mudafin ilay, right? Because it's only the ism can be mudaf mudafin ilay, right? This here is idafa, that means idafa means mudaf mudafin ilay. So the abd is mudaf, the who is mudafin ilay, the rasul is mudaf, the who is mudafin ilay, right? But it is a state of idafa, it's both of them together. So that is basically our i'rab on this, inshallah. And we should go back and study those words that we learn from it. Ashhadu, shahida, yashhadu, ashhada, istashhada, shahadatun, shahidun, shahidun, mashhudun. Those are all derivatives. Here we have some examples of the root sha, sheen, ha, and dal, and its derivatives in the Quran. We have the first thing, the first one that I brought, because this is very important. Shahidallahu. Shahida means he witnessed, right? Who is witnessing? Allah. Annahu. Anna means indeed, that indeed. Who? Indeed, this who goes back to Allah. That indeed he, what about him? La ilaha illahu. There is no deity. Shahida means he witnessed or to witness. There is no deity, absolutely no deity. Illa huwa. Illa huwa, Allah. Right? Goes back. So, wal malaikatu. And the malaika. The malaika is the angels. That is the plural form, right? Wa ulul ilm. Ulu are the people who possess those of al ilm. We know what is ilm. Those of knowledge. So who are witnessing? Listen, look at this ayah and you should learn this ayah. It's a very, very important ayah in chapter 3, ayah 18. The ayah says, Allah bears witness. Allah, can you imagine? Allah is telling us this. That he bears witness to what? To la ilaha illahu. There is no deity except him. He bears witness to this. Right? So this is fact. This is fact. There is no doubt about this. Allah, can you imagine this? Allah is telling us that he bears witness to this. Do you think there will be any lies? There cannot be because Allah does not lie. Allah is way above any deficiencies and lying is a deficiency. And Allah only speaks the truth. So he's telling us that he witnesses to la ilaha illallah. Illahu, which is la ilaha illallah. Right? The huwa is used because the noun Allah is used there. Who else is witnessing? The waw here is waw al-aqf. And al-malaika. And he's telling us, and the malaika witnesses to la ilaha illallah. And who else? Wa ulul ilm. And those of knowledge. The ignorant would not witness to la ilaha illallah. And when we do the conditions, then you would know what a witness entails, because there are seven conditions that must be fulfilled for a witness to be valid. So inshallah, we'll deal with that when we deal with the kalima, inshallah. But I hope you pay attention to this, right? Very serious ayah. Memorize it, pay attention to it, learn it, right? And these ayahs that I'm choosing are specifically chosen because of what they contain of important information for you and me as Muslims. Inna arsalna ilaykum rasulan shahidan alaykum. This is in Surah Muzammil. Inna arsalna. Inna is made up of two words. Inna and na. Indeed, we. What about what we did? Arsalna. Arsala yursilu means arsala yursilu. Remember I was discussing the four-letter verb when and a hamza is added. Rasala is the original word, right? That's the three letter. Then alif is added to it with the hamza. The ra, the fatah drops and it takes a sukun, right? So it becomes arsala, yursilu. As I said, there is only one form for this. The alamat al-mudar, which is ya in this case, the sign of it being a present tense, it takes a dhamma and the third letter, the ayn al-kalima, takes a kasra. Right? Arsala yursilu means to send. So inna, indeed we, Allah is saying, indeed we arsalna, we sent. Ilaykum, ila means to, kum, to you all of you. This is plural, right? Ilayka would be one. Ilaykum, indeed we sent to you all. What? A Rasul. We did just did Rasul. A Rasul, okay? A messenger. A messenger, who is Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Who is, what is it, what about him? Shahidan. He is going to be a shahid. As I said, a shahid is ismul fa'il. It is the one that is witnessing. He is going to be a witness, alaykum, against. In this case, ala means upon or against. Against all of you. So on the day of judgment, the Prophet ﷺ is going to stand for or against all of us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make him stand for us and be a witness for us. Ameen. Alright, this is in Surah. Indeed, we have sent to you a messenger as a witness unto you. Washahidin, this is in Surah Buruj. Washahidin, the one who witnesses. And by, Allah is swearing here, and by the witness, the one who witnesses, the shahid, and what is witness, the mashhood. As I said, this is a small maf'ool. وَهُمْ عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ شُهُودٌ وَهُمْ, and they, as in the disbelievers, are upon, عَلَى مَا يَفْعَلُونَ. فَعَلَى يَفْعَلُ means to do. فَعَلَى means to do, right? يَفْعَلُ means he did, he does. يفعلون means they do. Okay? What they did is plural. يفعلون. You add waw and noon. يفعلوا is a singular. You add waw and noon to end. It makes it, to the end, it makes it plural. That's like the jam of Zakr Salim. Like Muslim, Muslimun. This is the fa'al. This is, but the same thing happens. For the singular, you add to it a waw and a noon. It becomes plural. So, وهم على ما يفعلون. And they are upon what they do. Concerning or with or to bil mu'mineen, with the believers, shuhud, they are witnesses. Ashhad is plural for shahid and or shaheed, and shuhud is also not plural, right? So, and they, to what they do against believers or witnesses, or they witness, right? They were witnesses to what they did. Wa yakulu al-ashhadu, ashhad is a plural. Ha'ulai alladhina kathabu عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ هَعُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ كَذَبُوا عَلَى رَبِّهِمْ. The Ashhad are the witnesses, right? We did that already. Ashhad and Shuhud are witnesses. وَيَقُولُ الْأَشْهَادُ, so the Ashhad, the witnesses, are going to say, they will say, هَعُلَاءِ الَّذِينَ, though these are the ones who lied against their Lord. Ala Rabbihim, against their Lord. Right? As you see, the ala here is used as against or upon. Right? They lied upon Allah, they lied against Him, is the same kind of connotations. Right? So the witnesses are going to say on the day of judgment, these are the ones who lied against their Lord. So be careful. I mean, how you operate with Allah. Qul kafa. Qul means qala yakulu. Qul qala means say. He said. Yakulu. He says. Qul say. Kafa. Kafa means enough. Kafa yakfi, sufficient or enough. Kafa baini, kafa billahi shahidan. Say, it's enough that Allah is a shaheed, baini. Baina means between me and you. Right? Innahu kana bi'ibadihi, indeed he, Allah. So we are saying here that the Prophet ﷺ, Allah is telling the Prophet ﷺ to tell them, "Kafa billahi shahidan bayni wa baynakum." Allah is enough. Allah is sufficient as a witness between me and you. Innahu, indeed He, kana bi ibadihi. He was ever with concerning His ibad. Kana here is past tense, right? But it indicates continuity. بِعِبَادِهِ عَبْدٌ عِبَادِ is a slave, right? بِعِبَادِهِ خَبِيرًا. خَبِير comes from the word, you know, we did مُبْتَدَى and خَبَر. خَبَر means the one who's informed. He's acquainted. So he's acquainted. He was always acquainted concerning his ibad. And he was basir. Basir is one who sees everything. He is seeing concerning them. He sees everything, right? Sufficient is Allah as a witness between me and you. Indeed, he is ever concerning his servant, acquainted and seeing. So he's always seeing what they do. So there's nothing you can do to hide. So, I mean, I hope that all of this is helping you to really understand the majesty of Allah. ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ. Then you are going to be تُرَدُّون. ثُمَّ means then, right? تُرَدُّون, then they, it's supposed to be you. You will be returned back. It's not they will be returned back. It is you will be returned back. إِلَىٰ عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ, to the nur, to the alim, the nur, to the nur of al-ghayb. Al-ghayb is the unseen. وَالشَّهَادَة, and the witnessed. We did shahada already, right? فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ فَيُنَبِّئُ نَبَّأَ يُنَبِّئُكُمْ نَبَّأَ. And he is going to give, you know, نَبَّأَ, so نَبَّأَ, so نَبَّأَ is the news. نَبَّأَ means to inform. So he's going to inform you. He will inform you. So when you go back to him, you and me go back to him, he will inform us concerning بِمَا كُنْتُمْ, with what you were تعملون عمل يعمل تعملون, what they used to do, or what it's supposed to be, what you used to do. The they there is incorrect, right? It's supposed to be you, right? As you see, the translation has it correct. Then you will be taken back to the nor of the unseen and the witness. You and me will be taken back, and he will inform you of what you used to do. Categories of nouns derived from their source, right, which is the mustard, and the scales upon which they fall. They are here in this category here. What we are going to do is we are going to be giving you some of the categories, which we start doing already, but I am always saying, but here we are writing it down. There are many types of derived nouns. Each of these come with their individual scales that indicate the form to construct it. Each scale carries a particular implication which helps to bring out the meaning. So we're going to give you scales of these nouns that are derived, right? So you would know the meanings that they carry, because each scale carry a particular meaning. In this lesson, we are going to discuss some of the most popular derivatives, inshallah, and try to apply them to verbs that we studied. They are listed below. Nouns that are derived from the masdar, the source. The first one is ismul fa'il. Ismul fa'il. Second one is ismul maf'ul. Ismul maf'ul. The third one is اسم المبالغة أو أسماء المبالغة اسم التفضيل اسم التفضيل. And scales upon اسم المبالغة. There are some scales. Here we have اسم المبالغة. There are many scales that this that there are many scales of مبالغة in the Quran. Right? We're going to deal with some of them, inshallah, that occurs in the Quran with examples. So we're going to give some examples of that too. So here are the derivatives. Okay, ism al-fa'il is description in English, the one that does the action, the doer of the action, like the shahid. He's the one that does the witnessing, right? Its scale is fa'ilun. This is a scale. You take off the alif and lam, that's why it's called ism al-fa'il, right? It's the ism of al-fa'il, of the one that is doing the action, okay? So it is on a scale fa'ilun. An example of it, one who worships is abid. Abada is to worship. Abid is one who worships. Alima is to seek knowledge. Alim is the one who seeks knowledge, one who praises. Hamidun. Hamida is to praise. The one who prays is hamidun. The plural is hamidun. The plural for this is abidun. Wa ma antum abiduna is found in Surah Kafirun, right? Abid wa ma أنا عابد ما عبدتم ما عبدتم. I'm not an عابد. وما أنا عابد ما عبدتم وما أنتم عابدون ما عابد. Right? It is the ism al-fa'il. So you can understand the meaning now. I am not a worshipper of what you worship, and neither are you worshippers عابدون of what I worship. ما عابد. Ism al-maf'ul. The object upon which the action is carried out. It can be somebody or it can be something. Let us get the scale. It is on the scale maf'ul. Right? Maf'ul means the object upon which the action is carried out. So you have to learn the concepts, right? And notice how it is formed. Fa'ala is there. You add a meem at the beginning with a fatha. Maf'ulun. The one worshipped is the ma'bud. Allah is the true ma'bud. Al-ma'budu bihaq Allah. The ma'bud in truth is Allah. Every other ma'bud is false. Right? Every other ma'bud is false. The one praise is therefore, what would you say? It comes from hamida. The one praise would be mahmud. Mahmud. Then we have ism al-tafdil. Ism al-tafdil is to indicate comparative and superlative in the Arabic language. Right? It is one, in English, you say good, better, best. In Arabic, there is one form for it and falls on the scale af'alu. Af'alu. And we're going to explain a little bit about ism al-tafdil, inshallah. So the best worshipper is a'bad. A'badun nas. Right? And it is mamnu' min as-sarf. It doesn't take tanween. Mamnu' min as-sarf means it doesn't take tanween. The best one who prays would be ahmadu. So Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is called, his name also is ahmadu. So he's the best of those who praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, right? Ism al-mubalagha. The ism al-mubalagha, there are a few of these, inshallah, that we will have to deal with now. Nouns used for exaggeration. Mubalagha means exaggeration, right? So these are nouns used for exaggeration in the Quran. Fa'il, we did a scale already. Hamid, Hakim, Jamil, we did this already, all right? Servants would be, we are using the word abada, right? Abid, abidun are slaves, right? There are ibad too, but abid is slaves. Most praiseworthy would be, the most praiseworthy would be Hamid, Hamidun Majid. Allah is the most praiseworthy, right? So we did that already. Fa'ul, like affectionate, right? Wadud, Wadud, huwa al-ghafur al-wadud in Surah. And the word ghafur also is on the same scale, right? On the same scale, fa'ul, all forgiving, right? Ghafur al-wadud, ghafur al-wadud is in Surah Buruj. Well, Ghafur al-Wadud, he is the all-forgiving, the affectionate, Allah Akbar, the most loving. Then we have Fa'al, Fa'al, he does whatever, Fa'al, he does whatever he wants. Fa'alun lima yurid is in Surah Buruj again, right? Fa'alun lima yurid. Okay, so those are the three scales that we have from that. So we have, like this one here, we have Ghafur, right? But Ghaffar, who is a perpetual forgiver, falls on the scale fa'al. Ism al-zarf. Ism al-zarf, these are the time or place. These are ism of time and place when the action is carried out. The time when the action is carried out or the place that the action is carried out, right? So we have maf'alun, like a desk. The place of the writing, right, is maktab. Maktab, makan al-kitaba. Makan al-kitaba, or makan al-kitabatin, the place of writing is maktabun, a desk. See, it falls on the same scale here, right? Maf'alun. There is maf'alatun, a school, the place of studying, right? So it is madrasatun. Madras, and the ta is that, is maf'al. Just the ta of marbuta is added on it here. Madrasatun, right? Is makanu dirasa. Makanu dirasatin, right? Is the place of study. Okay. Makan means a place, right? Maf'ilun, this is maf'alun, and this is maf'ilun, right? So it's just a matter of changing around the fatha into a kasra. One is maf'alun and one is maf'ilun. Sunset, the time the sunset, right? And it can also be a place, right? Maghrib. Maghrib. Maghrib is the time or the place. So it's ism al-zarf, as the noun relating to time or place. Okay? So learn them. Here are some examples of the ism al-fa'il and the ism al-maf'ul. So we have sa'ala. Sa'ala means to ask. It's masdar is mas'alatun. Mas'alatun. Mas'ala means a question, right? Or an issue. The question or the issue. Okay, ism al-fa'il for it is going to be sa'ilun. Sa'ala sa'ilun bi'adhabin waqi'ah. Concerning a punishment that is going to waqi'ah. Waqi'ah means to happen. A questioner. Sa'ala sa'il, a questioner. Sa'al, ask. What did he ask? سَعَلَ بِعَذَابٍ وَعَكِعٍ, concerning a punishment that is going to occur. لِلْكَافِرِينَ لَيْسَ لَهُ دَافِعٍ, for the kafir, for those who are ungrateful and the disbeliever, they have no way of pushing it back. They have no way of avoiding it. Allahu Akbar. You know, so when you hear Allah talks this thing in the Quran, I mean, it really drives home a point that you better be a Muslim. You know, better be a Muslim. There's no way out of this. The questioner, Mas'ul, means the one asked. To witness is shahida yashhadu ishhad. Shahida yashhadu ishhad. This word is sa'ala yas'alu is'al. All right, this is the fi'l amr. And this one is shahadatun. Shahadatun is the masdar. It means witnessing. Ismul fa'il is shahidun. We did that already. It is the one who is witnessing. Mashhudun is the witnessed. The thing that is witnessed. Okay? Then we have to create. Khalaqa yakhluku uqluq. Uqluq. Khalaqa yakhluku uqluq. Means, and khalqun is the master. Khalaqa means to create, or he created. Yakhluku means he creates. Uqluq means create. Khalqun is creating or the creation. Right? Khalikun is the creator. Makhluq is the creation. Is the thing that is created or the creature. Makhluq. Rafa'a yarfa'u irfa' means to raise. Rafa'a means to raise. Yarfa'u means he raises. Irfa' rafa'a yadain. You know, talk about rafa'u yadain, raising the two hands. Yadain is two hands. Irfa' yadak, raise your hand. Rafa'un means the raising. Okay, rafi' is the one who raises. Marfu', you know the word marfu'? The dhamma is marfu', it is raised. So it is marfu', the dhamma is raised above the letter. So that is why it is marfu', it is raised above. The thing raised, the dhamma is raised. Anyways, let us get some examples here from what we did before. You know, بعد الصيغ المضارع والأمر للمذكر والمفرد والجمع. So these are verbs that we did that I want to do back so that we know the mufrad muzakkar and the jam' muzakkar for the first, second and third person, so that at least when we get into the fi'l mudhari it would be easy. Tadhakkara yatadhakkaru, dhakara is its root. We did this already, so I'm going to run through this. He remembered is tadhakkar. He remembers is yatadhakkaru. Okay, tadhakkar is the fi'l amr. Tadhakkaru. For the fi'l amr, the jam' is, this is mufrad, this is jam', right? So the noon drops off, so it becomes tadhakkaru. Remember you, all. And remember you, singular. That's tadhakkar. Is singular. Tadhakkaru is plural. It's a command. Yatadhakkaru. Yatadhakkaruna. Yatadhakkaru means he remembers, right? Yatadhakkaruna means they remember. Okay? Tatadhakkaru means you remember. Tatadhakkaruna means you remember, plural. Atadhakkaru means I remember. Natadhakkaru means we remember. Aflaha, qad aflaha al-mu'minun. The mu'minun are successful. Aflaha yuflihu means he succeeded. Yuflihu means he succeeds. Aflaha means he succeeded. Yuflihu means he succeed. They come from the verb, the root fa, lam, and ha. So, what is the fi'l amr here? Aflih. It comes from the fi'l mudari, right? So you drop the dhamma there and takes a sukun and you add an alif in front. We're going to discuss this. Aflih. Aflihu. It's aflahu is wrong, right? Aflihu. Okay? Succeed, you alone. Aflihu is succeed all of you. Okay? So this is wrong. We have to change that. Yuflihu. Yuflihuna. We took yuflihu from here. Yuflihuna. Yuflihu means he succeeds. Yuflihuna means they succeed. Tuflihu means you succeed. Tuflihuna means you succeed, plural. Uflihu means I succeed. Nuflihu means we succeed. Right? You just follow the pattern, inshallah. I did this already. Tafakkara yatafakkaru. Right? It comes from the root fakkara. Fa, kaf, and ra. The ta is added, and the shadda, the additional kaf is added here. It means to ponder or to reflect upon, right? So tafakkara means he reflected. Yatafakkaru means he reflects. But all of these are used. لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَذَكَّرُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يُفْلِحُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَفَكَّرُونَ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. You understand? That's why I brought them back, because of the لَعَلَّ. Remember we did that? تَفَكَّر. Ya walad. Think, reflect. تَفَكَّرُوا. Ya nas. Reflect, all of you, O people. Right? يَتَفَكَّرُوا. يَتَفَكَّرُونَ means he reflect. He reflects. يَتَفَكَّرُونَ means they reflect. تَتَفَكَّرُوا means you reflect. تَتَفَكَّرُونَ means you plural reflect. أتفكروا means I reflect. نتفكروا means we reflect. Okay. رجع يرجع means to return. Right? He returned and he returns. It comes from رجع. را جيم عين. That is its roots, the جذر. Right? He returned, he returns. ارجع. ارجع. ارجعوا. Return all of you home. ارجعوا إلى بيوتكم. Right? It means return. Or all of you return. يَرْجِعُ يَرْجِعُونَ. He returns, they return. تَرْجِعُ تَرْجِعُونَ. You return, you all return. أَرْجِعُ نَرْجِعُ. I return, we return. Right? Then we have finally, رَحِمَ يَرْحَمُ. We all want this. It comes from the verb, first of all, from the جِزْر. Its جِزْر is رَحَ and meem. Very easy to figure out. And it means, he was merciful. Right? And يرحم means he is merciful. This is incorrect here, right? So we have إرحم. إرحموا. إرحم والديك. Be merciful to your parents, right? Be merciful you. إرحموا آباءكم. Be merciful all of you to your parents, right? يرحموا. This here is called فعل مبني للمجهول. It's a passive voice. يرحموا يرحمون means he obtains mercy. They obtain mercy. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. تُرْحَمُوا تُرْحَمُونَ. لَا. So that you may obtain mercy. You individually as a singular person, تُرْحَم. تُرْحَمُون means you all would be obtain mercy. أُرْحَمُ. نُرْحَمُ means I obtain mercy, we obtain mercy. So that's basically it, inshallah. Just reflect on it and deal with it. We're going to recite Surah An-Naas. And we're going to give its meaning. You are supposed to know that, so it's not going to be any kind of big going explanation. And we're going to introduce Ghunnah. And we're going to give the one benefit from this surah. And then we're going to do Surah At-Takaathus, inshallah. So let us move. Tajweed. First thing is that we're going to talk about today is Al-Ghunnah. Al-Ghunnah. And it occurs a lot in Surah An-Naas. That is why I bring it here, inshallah. And it is something that, you know, we can start practicing anytime we see it. It's a vibration or humming sound that occurs in the nasal passage. It occurs where? In the nasal passage, right? It is present only in the pronunciation of the letters noon and meem. An, right? If I close my nose, you're going to hear the difference. An, you hear the difference. You hear as if it is forcing itself to come through the nose. You hear the difference. Whenever a noon or a meem has a shaddah, that is any time you see it in the Quran, any time you're reading, so you have to start practicing this. Anytime a noon or a meem has a shaddah above it, that's like this, meem or noon with shaddah, the sound of the Ghunnah is prolonged for approximately two harakat, two beats, right? Two beats, inshallah. So anytime you see a noon or meem with shaddah, and that is found in Surah An-Naas, so much, right? The Ghunnah is prolonged. You don't say inna. You say inna. Amma yata. You don't say amma yatasa'alun. You say amma yatasa'alun. Innal insana. Right? So let us get the Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Right? We're going to give the meaning first. Qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. What does it mean? Can you remember? It means say, I seek protection with the Lord of mankind. How much of us have that? See if you can get all the meaning. You're supposed to know the meaning of these words, these surahs, right? I'm bringing back each surah, one surah for every class. So revise it so you can know the meaning. Malikin Nas. Malik is a king, right? Malikin Nas, the king of mankind. Ilahin Nas. Ilahin Nas. Ilahin Nas is a God or a deity, the ilah of mankind, the God or the deity of mankind. Min sharril waswasil khannas, from the evil of the waswas. Waswas is the whispering of al-khannas. Al-khannas is one who comes and whispers when we are heedless. And he runs away when we remember Allah, right? From the evil of the whisperer, that is the devil who whispers evil in the hearts of men, who withdraws from his whispering in one heart when one remembers Allah. So when you remember Allah, he moves away, right? Because you see, the heart cannot contain two things at any given time. You just sit down and try to think of two things at any given time. Think it. You can't. It's impossible. So if shaitan is coming to you with whispers, and there is no remembrance of Allah, he's going to get in. But if there is remembrance of Allah, there's something already in the heart, he's not going to get in. So that is what it means, the khannas, is one who whispers when people are negligent and he withdraws. Actually, khannas has to do with withdrawal. He withdraws when people are under remembrance of Allah. Alladhi yuwaswisu fi suduri nas. Who? The khannas is the devil, right? Alladhi hu yuwaswisu. Waswasa yuwaswisu is a verb. Who whispers fi sudurinas, into the chests of men, right? Min al jinnati wan nas, min al jinnati wan nas, from amongst jinn and mankind. Let us read this with tajweed, with practicing on this, on the noon. Noon is emphasized here, right? As you see, with shaddah. I said every time it is read, you give ghunnah. So let us go. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. قل أعوذ برب الناس ملك الناس إله الناس من شر الوسواس الخناس الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس من الجنة والناس. Get it? Right now, the most important thing is, you know what is a gunna? Is a nasal sound. And it is going to be on the meem and the noon when they have shaddah. In this surah Nas, it is full of it, inshallah, on the Nas and al-Khannas and al-Jinnah. Okay? So read it. When you read the surah Nas now, practice that, inshallah. Okay. Qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Alam tara ayatin unzilatil layla lam yura mithluhunna qat qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq wa qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas. This is related by Muslim. And Uqbat ibn Amir qal, amarani Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an aqra'a bil mu'awwidhati dubara kulli salatin. Abu Dawud. An Uqbat ibn Amir qal, amarani Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam an aqra'a bil mu'awwidhati dubara kulli salatin. أمرني قال عن عقبة بن عامر قال أمرني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أن أقرأ بالمعوذات دبر كل صلاة. أبو داود. Okay, so we have two hadith there. We have together meaning ألم ترى, ألم ترى كيف, do you not see, آيات, آيات is آيات. Unzilat. Anzala, unzila means to be. Alam tara means do you not, don't you see. Unzilat come from anzala. Unzila is fi'l mabni lil majhul. It's a passive voice. Was revealed, right? Was or were revealed. Al-layla. Al-layla is a night. Alam tara ayatin unzilat al-layla. Don't you see or don't you recognize ayats were revealed this night. All right, or the night. Lam yura mithluhunna qat. Lam yura. You see, tara, yura. Yura is fi'l mabni lil majhul. Lam yura has never been seen, was never seen. Lam yura mithluhunna. Mithl means like. Hunna means like them. Qat. Qat means ever. Ever, you never see like them, right? Qul a'udhu bi rabbil falaq or qul a'udhu bi rabbin nas, right? And then he said, amarani. قال أمرني أمر, and we have نون الوقاية here, right? أمرني, the ya here is متكلم. He commanded me. He said أمرني رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم commanded me. Uqba ibn Amir is saying that the Prophet ﷺ commanded me an aqra'a, right? An aqra'a, to aqra, that I read, or that I read, to read, or that I read, bil mu'awwidhati, mu'awwidhat is the two surahs. With which protection is sought, that's what it means, right? The two surahs with which protection is sought, that's what al-mu'awwidhati here means, right? Dubura, we did dubura already, means at the end, or behind, or after. Kulli salatin, dubura kulli salatin, after every salat, after every or all salat, right? So, Allah's Messenger said, what wonderful verses. I mean, that is Alam Tara. They are translating like this, but it actually means, don't you see, or don't you reflect, or tell me. Verses have been sent down today or tonight, the like of which has never been seen. They are, say, I seek refuge with the Lord of the dawn, and I seek refuge with the Lord of men. This is narrated by Muslim. Narrated Uqba ibn Amir, the Messenger of Allah commanded me to recite Al Mu'awwidhat, the two surahs of the Quran, after every prayer. Dubura, dubura kulli salatin, after every prayer, at the end of every prayer, right? So these are two things that you should practice also. You know, they are beautiful surahs. They were never revealed to any other people before. We are the first people that have this, so it's a blessing, mashallah. And the second thing is, you should ponder the meaning of these surahs. It's real, real protection. It's real, real heavy protection, you know. And it is recommended to recite it every day after every salat. Every salat, sorry, not every day. Let me come to Soorah At-Takaathus. So let us, inshallah, start. We're going to read. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. So we take it down back, inshallah, and we just bring an ayah at a time. You know the meaning of أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, which is I seek refuge with Allah from the cursed, or the accursed Satan, who's the devil. So it can be from the cursed Satan, or the cursed devil, or the accursed Satan, or the accursed devil. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, you know the meaning of that also. In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the especially merciful. The first ayah is Al-Hakumut Takathur. Here, the kum is damir. Al-Ha, its mudari is Yulhi. It's like on the same scale of Anzala Yunzilu, Af'ala Yuf'ilu. This alif here is added. The original word, the original root is La, Ha, and Ya. Alif is added, so it becomes Al-Ha. And the mudari takes a Dhamma instead of a Fatha. Yulhi, one form, Yuf'il. And it means to divert or distract. So Al-Hakum, something is distracting you, according to this ayah. Al-Hakum At-Takaathur is what is diverting you or distracting you. What is At-Takaathur? Takathur comes from ka-tha-ra, which the word kathir comes from, which is plenty, many. Here, because of takathur, it is like a competition between people because of the scale it falls on. So this is many or increase, right? Distracts you. You're distracted. If it's kathir, you're distracted by many, many things. But here is the competition for increase distracts you. When Allah talks about increase here, He means the worldly increase. So al-hakum at-takathur, it would translate to mean competition in worldly increase distracts or diverts you from what you're supposed to be really concentrating on. As Muslims, we know what is the real end. The real end is the Akhirah, is the Day of Judgment. This is the real end. And Allah is telling us that competition for worldly increase distracts us, all of us, and we are all guilty. But it is not a good thing. It is something that is bad. If you consider the next ayah, because Allah says, competition in worldly increase distracts you. Hatta zurtumul maqabir. Hatta means until, right? Zara yazuru, zur means to visit. Zurtum is the plural. Zurtum, you all, right? You all, because you all are distracted, right? Here, zurtum means you visited, or you visit. Hatta zurtumul maqabir, until you visit al-maqabir. Al-maqabir is the graveyards. Comes from the single of it is maqbara, which is one graveyard. But different, we are differently, all of us, going to different graveyards. So Allah is telling us that competition in the worldly increase diverts you until you visit the grave, until you visit the graveyards. Right? This is when you die. This is not talking about just going and visit to take somebody to bury them. This is talking about when we die and we reach a graveyard. That is what is important here. So Allah is telling us this piling up for worldly increase is diverting us till death. So we have to be careful. We have to be very, very careful, because this is our problem. We are diverted with what we should not be diverted with, as Allah says, Kalla sawfa ta'alamun. Kalla, no, nay, you should never have been diverted with worldly increase until you visit your graves. Because sawfa means you will. Ta'alamun, alima ya'alamu means to know. Ta'alamu means you know. Ta'alamun means you all know. So he's addressing us directly. Competition in worldly increases diverts you until you visit your graves. And this distraction should not have been the case. So kalla, no, you are surely going to know that this should not have been your diversion. You should have been diverted instead with seeking the Akhirah. Right? Here Allah says, ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. Then, ثُمَّ means then, كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ, you're going to know. So Allah is emphasizing, then no, this should never have been the case, and you are going to know. So this is really a serious problem. كَلَّا, again Allah says, كَلَّا, no, this should not have been your situation. You should not have been diverted by increase until you visit the graveyards. And you are going to know, you are surely going to know, right? You should never have been in this case. Kalla law, if means if only. Ta'alamuna, ta'alamuna again, if only you know with a ilm. Ilm is knowledge, with a knowledge that is yaqeen, and ilm al-yaqeeni, which is certain knowledge. Kalla law ta'alamuna ilm al-yaqeen, yaqeen means knowledge. Ilm means knowledge, yaqeen means certainty. Nay, if only you knew with knowledge of certainty what is the reality. If only you knew with knowledge of certainty, latarawunna al-jaheem. Tarawunna comes from tara, comes from the word, you know, ra'a, yara, alam, tara. Lam here is for tawkeed, is for emphasis. Tara means you see. Tarawul here means you all see. It's plural, because Allah is talking in the plural all the time. He's addressing all of us. La tarawunna, you will definitely see. The noon here is called noon tawkeed, which is for emphasis. The lam and the noon, they normally come together like this for emphasis, for serious emphasis. Allah says that tarawunna al-jahim, you will surely see. You will surely see al-jahim. Al-jahim is jahannam, right? Is hellfire. You will surely see the hellfire. ثُمَّ لَتَرَوُنَّهَا عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ. لَتَرَوُنَّ, then you will surely, لَتَرَوُنَّ, you will surely see it. Ha refers to jahim. عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ. عَيْنَ الْيَقِينَ is the عَيْنَ of certainty. You will, if you had If you had known, you know, with certainty of knowledge, that would have been good for you. But here he is talking about an ayn al-yaqeen, which is the ayn, the eye of certainty. You are seeing it in, with surety. You're not, it's not illusion anymore. It's something that you're just hearing about. Right? Then Allah says, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. Then, لَتُسْأَلُنَّ. لَتُسْأَلُنَّ سَأَلَ means to ask. تُسْأَلُنَّ again is noon, lam for tawqeed and noon for tawqeed. It's for emphasis. سَأَلَ means to ask. You will surely be asked. You will surely be asked. لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ on that day about عَنْ النَّعِيمِ. Na'im is bounties. Right, then you will surely be asked that day about the delight, the bounties. I prefer to say the bounties or the pleasure of the or the benefits and the you indulge in this worldly life. The worldly things that you indulge in, you're going to be questioned about it. So, brothers and sisters, this ayah, this series of ayat is very coherent and the subject is very straight up. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dealing it in a practical way which we should all pay attention to, so that inshallah on the day of judgment we would be prepared, because we would not be distracted by with the competition of increase until we visit the graveyard. Because if we are distracted, we will definitely come to know with a surety, with certain knowledge that we will see Jahim, and we will see it with the eye of certain. Then the reality is that we are going to be asked on that day about the delights of this world pleasure. Really, really, really hits the point of our problem. Our problem is this. This is our problem. Brothers and sisters, so take care. Words that we should know, that we have to be familiar with as Muslims, and we are dealing with words from the Salat, at-Tahiyaat. The last rak'ah is a pillar of the Salat. Right, in the last rak'ah, it's a pillar of the salat. If it's left out, it has to be repeated. The shahra has to be done back, and sahu sijah has to be done. This here is a rukn of the salat. This has different rulings. Okay, if it is left out, then the salat can be invalid. If you finish a prayer and you didn't pray, then the salat can be invalid. So be careful, inshallah. So you have to know this. Okay, let's read it. At-Tahiyaatu lillahi. At-Tahiyaatu lillahi. Was-salawatu. Was, the waw is flat. Sad is wrong. Was-salawatu. Same thing here. The ta is wrong. The waw is flat. Don't say wat-tayyibat. Say wat-tayyibatu. Don't say was or was. The waw is not wrong. It's was-salawatu. And if you say was, it's the scene. وَالطَّيِّبَاتُ السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكَ أَيُّهَا النَّبِيُّ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ السَّلَامُ عَلَيْنَا وَعَلَى عِبَادِ اللَّهِ الصَّالِحِينَ أَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهُ وَحْدَهُ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ. Right, let us read it back one more time. At-tahiyyatu lillahi was-salawatu, not was-salawatu, was-salawatu, not wat-tayyibatu, wat-tayyibatu. As-salamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyyu wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As-salamu alayna wa ala ibadillahi s-salihin. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Okay, so what does this mean? التحيات means التحيات is for Allah. What is التحيات? التحيات, any word that is used to indicate the glorification of Allah, His eternal existence, His perfection and His sovereignty, is all included under at-tahiyyat. At-tahiyyatu lillah. So all of this is only for Allah. Okay? Was-salawatu. Wat-tayyibatu. As-salawat is all acts of worship. As-salawatu is all acts of worship. At-tayyibat is all the good deeds. All good deeds. Because Allah only accepts good. All acts of worship and good deeds are for Him. Okay, so when you read At-Tahiyyatu Lillah, think about what you're saying and how you're glorifying Allah with all these important things that relate to him. As-salamu alayka. As-salamu alayka. Salam upon you, ayyuhan nabiyyu. Sheikh al-Albani in his book says, if you say salamu ala nabi, it is not bid'ah. Because some of your companions did that. So you can say that too, inshallah. Okay. But this seemed to be the one that is more consensus about in dealing with, because I was discussing it with somebody and they said that if so many people were saying it and doing it in the time of Prophet and nobody was doing it in Carrefour, then it means that it is allowed, because it is the entire ummah really doing it at that time. Salamu alayka ayyuhan nabiyyu wa rahmatullah. Rahmatullah is the mercy of Allah. So salam is peace upon you, ayyuhan nabiyyu, O Prophet. Wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And his rahmah and his mercy and his blessings and his barakat upon the Prophet, right? Blessings, barakah is blessings. Barakat is barakatun is blessings. Barakat is blessings. Peace and mercy and blessings of Allah be upon you, O Messenger of Allah. As-salamu alayna. And peace be upon us, alayna, upon us. Wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Wa ala ibadillahi salihin. Right, peace. Ibad is slaves. As-salihin are righteous slaves. Peace be upon us and all the righteous servants. So when you say this, brothers and sisters, you are saying it for every righteous creation, including the jinns, including the angels, right? So you're sending salam to them, mashallah, right? So, and you're asking for peace of Allah upon them, inshallah. I ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. And I witness there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah, who is alone and has no partners, right? And I witness that Muhammad is his abd, his slave, and his messenger. Now, why did I have this in bracket? Because there are two different versions. You can say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh, or you can say this, which I prefer to do, wahdahu la sharika lah, more meaning, more blessings, inshallah, because they're both authentic. And I bear witness that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. The Tajweed page, illustration of the body part from which speech originate the upper palate. We're just going to finish here, inshallah. This is the upper palate. The upper palate is the top of your mouth. We call it the roof. Okay? Okay. If you look at it, this is the side view. And this is the side view here of the upper palate. And this is the front view of the upper palate. This is what, viewing it from the front. You're watching it as if you're holding it in your hand. Okay? So how many portions there are? There's the gum. And all of these are important portions, right? As we're going to see when we're going to do pronunciation of the letters in Arabic. The gum, and you'll see how meticulous the Arabic language is in relation to pronunciation, inshallah. There's the gum, there's the front part, that is this part here, right? The front part, that is not going on beyond, it's going at the front there, right? Inshallah. Then there's the hard palate. So it is before the hard palate, right? This is the hard palate here. The hard palate is here. And then we have the soft palate. The soft palate. This piece here. And then we have the final piece is the uvula. The uvula is at the bottom there, inshallah. Okay? So the gum. We know the gums. Everybody know the gums. I wanted to put in the Arabic, but inshallah, we'll deal with that later. The front part. When we go back to discuss it, inshallah, the makharij, we'll deal with the Arabic. The front part of the upper palate. The upper palate, the front part, and then the hard palate, then the soft palate, and the uvula. These are the different parts of the palate, and the tongue interacts with it to bring out the sound. So we close here, inshallah. This concludes our fifth lesson at Dars al-Khamis of Part 2 of Foundation 1. It is our 21st lesson, Dars al-Hadi wal-Ishrun, overall for Foundation 1. I ask Allah to keep our hearts firm and intentions pure. Furthermore, I encourage everyone. I encourage everyone to learn this great dua and repeat it often. Allahumma anfa'ni bima 'allamtani wa'allimni ma yanfa'uni wa zidni ilma. Allahumma anfa'ni bima 'allamtani. Oh Allah, benefit me from what you've taught me. Wa'allimni ma yanfa'uni, and teach me what would benefit me. Wa zidni ilma, and increase me with knowledge. Right? But we close here, inshallah. And we close with the dua that we close with. And we ask Allah to bless us and guide us, help us and strengthen us to do what is right. Keep us away from what is evil. Bless us and guide us and strengthen us to do what is good. Keep away from all that is evil. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك وبارك الله فيكم. And may Allah reward you all for the efforts you're making, because you're giving me an opportunity to do this. I run and make a lot of effort to go over all the lessons. Please, I'm begging you. It's going to make it very, very easy. Anytime you get any spare time, it's only this time. It's only this 2 years. Spend it as if you're going to university and you are doing a university degree. And you have to spend time and make time. And do it. Make the time for it. And inshallah, you're going to see the rewards. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdik, shadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.